Hey guys, it's Dom, and I want to thank you for choosing Texas Pride and congratulate you on the purchase of your 16K bumper pull two-car hauler. At Texas Pride, we know we're living in unpredictable times, and there's occasions when our customers can't pick their trailers up themselves, so they either have it delivered or have someone pick it up for them, which means missing out on the final stage of the delivery process, the operational maintenance walk-around, which is usually done by one of our customer service reps. So today, this walk-around is just for you. So we'll begin at the front and work our way around, starting with the safety breakaway switch. So what you'll do is, you'll untie the cord, you're gonna take the carabiner, you're gonna attach that to the inside of the bed of the truck. That way, if the trailer gets away from you, this pin will pop out, locking the brakes on the trailer. I want to add one more thing about the safety breakaway switch, and it's regarding the breakaway battery box. Once that pin is pulled, it immediately starts to drain the battery on the box. So once your situation is under control, you want to pop that pin back in, because as I said, it's going to continue to drain the battery the entire time it's out. And some people will actually park their trailer and actually pull that pin out for overnight, just for theft prevention. But as I said, the entire time that it's out, it's going to drain their battery. Which means that the next morning when they come out and hook their trailer up, they pop that pin back in thinking that their safety breakaway switch is actually working when it's not. So you always want to check the charge on the battery box. At the nose of the trailer, you have your adjustable coupler along with two safety chains. Right in front of the toolbox, you have the jack handle that you use to raise and lower your 12,000 pound drop lid jack. And what you'll do is pull this out. Now, if you want to raise it, you're going to go clockwise. If you want to lower it, you'll go counterclockwise. And then you just take it and place it right back there. Now we're going to go ahead and take a look inside your toolbox. Inside the toolbox, you'll find your tie-down straps along with your ratchets. You can also use the toolbox for storing other tools. And inside it, you'll also see your 7-way electrical plug that you use to plug into the back of your truck. Behind the toolbox, you have a receiving hitch for if you decide to attach a winch to the trailer. If you purchase a spare tire with your trailer, then it's going to be mounted right here on the right side. On the right side of the trailer, you're going to see that you have lifetime LED lights on all sides of the trailer. The trailer is also wrapped with DOT reflective tape, so you'll never have a problem being seen on the highway at night. The trailer comes equipped with 14-ply tires that have 85 pounds of air pressure in them, along with 110 on torquing the lugs, and they're running on tandem 8,000-pound axles that have all-wheel electrical braking on all axles. And you can pop this rubber grommet out with a flathead screwdriver so you can grease the bearings. Now that's something you're gonna wanna do every 2,000 to 3,000 miles. You also have a grease point right here on the equalizer. Now that's something you're gonna wanna check every other load. Your ramps are gonna be stored at the rear of the trailer. And to get them out, you're gonna go like this. Pull that pin down, slide it out, open up that little door, and then you'll reach under here and you'll slide the ramps out and attach one right here and one right here, just like in this clip. The standard flooring on the two-car hauler is going to be 24-inch diamond plate with open centers, but you do have the option of upgrading to a perforated floor if you want to give yourself more tie-down options. For a good majority of our customers, tying down a vehicle on a car hauler isn't new to them, but we do have customers that are just getting started in the hotshot business and that actually never had to tie a car down on a car hauler. So I'm going to show you how to do that real quickly. So once you have your vehicle on the trailer, you're going to take the first strap and you're going to run that all the way over the tire, and you're going to pick a middle pooch hole, but you want to pick the one that's closest to the tire and hook it in like that. And then you're going to take your three rubber cleats, you're going to spread them out. The first one will go near the bottom of the tire. The second one will go near the top of the tire. And the third one will go, once again, near the bottom of the tire. And then you take your other hook and go into the center pooch hole that's closest to the tire once again. And then you'll come back to your ratchet. Hook that in. And then start ratcheting. And the effect will be as such. So all the features on this side of the trailer, like the LED lights, your DOT tape, and your grease points are gonna be identical to the other side of the trailer. But the one thing I didn't show you was your stake pockets that you have running down on both sides of the trailer. The deck on the trailer is 102 inches wide with drive-over fenders, which gives you larger vehicle hauling options. Once again, I'm Dom, and I hope this brief walk around of your two-car hauler helped you to get to know your trailer a little bit better. But if you still have questions, don't hesitate to give us a call or visit us at texaspridetrailers.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the road.